This is the Ludlow Pork Show on the Fun Seekers Radio Network, broadcasting from the Falcon Inn and Conference Center in Suwanee, Georgia. Ludlow Show brought to you in part by Telstar International Communications, by Jasper Jeep. No matter where you live, your Jeep dealership is in Jasper, Georgia. By Allerpure from Allergy Free, and by the Appalachian Lights at Burt's Farm. The toll-free line's now open at 1-800-572-TALK. And now, here's Ludlow Porch.
Well, good morning, fun seekers. Hi, y'all. Hope you're in a good mood today. We're going to have a good time. We're talking about just about anything on your mind at 1-800-572-8255. Let us get right back to our phones, because we got some folks been on hold for a long time. I guess the thrust of what we're talking about is what really starts your holiday season, but we won't have to talk about that. Whatever else may be on your mind, it's fair game. Albany, Georgia, and my friend Ed. Hello, Ed.
Ludlow.
How you doing,
cousin? What's new and exciting?
Not much, not much. I thought about you. We were talking about menus a few minutes ago for the holiday season. I thought to myself, I wonder what he is having for Thanksgiving dinner at his house.
Well, I guess I kind of got my dessert a little early. My mother-in-law came into town yesterday.
Uh-huh.
And that certainly didn't help anything. Before we get into that, Ludlow, you know, I always listen to your show really because I find it, you know, just so humorous. I really don't think of it as an educational program.
Uh-huh.
But the other day, y'all were doing that show on onions.
Uh-huh.
And that lady called in with that wonderful, wonderful idea about not crying.
Mm-hmm.
If you open your mouth.
Yeah.
You remember that?
Yeah, I do remember that.
In my house, it works the opposite. If I open my mouth, I start crying. anyway, she's been...
Okay.
It's been unbelievable. She's going to go make a chicken track cake. You ever heard of that?
Now, this is your... You're talking about your mother-in-law. Is this your mother, or, I mean, your wife or your mother?
Yeah, a joint effort here.
Oh, okay. A chicken track...
cake.
Never have.
From scratch.
Never have.
And, well, they've gone 6 hours yesterday looking for a box of scratch in a store. And, but what happens is you're supposed to have a chicken.
Uh-huh.
You take chocolate on top of the white frosting, Ludlow.
Yeah.
Is the way it's supposed to be, and you just kind of just like make your own designs with the chocolate.
Uh-huh.
On top of the white frosting, give it some kind of little design looking kind of thing, you
know?
Yeah,
yeah.
But, of course, ours didn't quite turn out that way.
What happened?
Well, I didn't know they could find somebody that actually owned a chicken. Because we don't live in the country.
Had to drive out to do that.
But on a serious note before I go, Ludlow, have you heard about people that are starting to fry turkeys?
Yeah.
Now, see, if you would, someone out there, because you have just such a large audience, will know how to seriously do that. And I've heard about that, and I've heard people tell me it's delicious.
Oh, we covered that the other day completely. I wish you'd have been listening.
Have been at the urinal, you know, with the previous eating problem.
How long you cook it, how hot, the whole, we did the whole thing.
Oh, man. I'm kind of scared to let her try that.
Yeah, I wouldn't. She's not a real good cook, according to what you say.
Well, like I told you, it keeps the dog from begging at the table.
I know.
Ludlow, you have a great Thanksgiving.
All right, buddy, you do the same. Glad you called.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. Yeah, we covered that fully. I didn't make any notes on that because I didn't have any idea I'd ever do that. Normally, when we get a good recipe in here, I'll keep the notes for 2 or 3 days to see if anybody's going to call in and ask about it, and they didn't. So we didn't do anything with it. Our number 1-800-572-8255. Boy, we're having fun now. Ludlow and Denny on the Fun Seekers Radio Network. As we head into what's going to be a long weekend for an awful lot of you folks out there. So congratulations and enjoy it and get together with somebody special and eat too much. Ought to just wasted some advice there. Listen, told you for a lot of years about the original allergies. 10 to noon on News Radio 960, the new WRFC. Fun now. Aiken, South Carolina. Henry on the radio. Hello, Henry.
Hello. Enjoy your show. This is the first time caller.
We're glad you're with us, buddy.
And my wife's just stumbled onto it, running through the FM dial. We wish we could pick you up, Ella, but we need you in a town a little closer to us.
All right.
But you can't be everywhere. The name of your book, and can we get it in a bookstore?
The name of the book is, you can get it in a bookstore, and the name of it's the new book, and I don't know whether they'll have any of the old ones or not, because those are kind of getting scarce, but the name of the new one is You're Sitting on Boomy, B-O-O-M-E-Y.
You're Sitting?
On Boomy.
And that's the last one, the latest one?
Yes, sir.
Okay, I heard you play background music occasionally, and I don't know if you selected that or if the producer selected that, but it seemed like I heard something by the Gleason Slaw Brothers three or four or 5 weeks ago, they were not picking the mandolin and singing. He was doing comedy, I think, just talking.
We got a bunch of those.
Okay, are those available on cassette or something?
Well, I'm sure. Check with your local record store, and I bet you they got it or can get it for you.
Yeah, it wouldn't be singing and picking. I don't think the one you had. It was just.
It's a mixture, I think.
Mixture.
The whole thing.
Okay. Is Swan in there, Atlanta?
Yes, sir. About 30 miles north.
Okay. Do you go back in the days? Y'all talk about country music on there a lot. I'm a bluegrass fan. But do y'all go back? Do you go back as far as the Erlanger Theater years ago when they had all these pickers on there?
I remember it being talked about. I don't think I was ever there or ever saw it, but I've heard folks talk about it.
That's uh-huh.
A vaudeville house, actually.
Is that right?
Started out, it's my understanding. Uh-huh.
Uh-huh. Well, you cover the South?
Yes, sir, pretty much.
Uh-huh. Well, we sure do enjoy your show. We got some talk shows around here, but they talk about people and run them down. You never talk about it. You never run down anybody.
Sometimes I just can't stand it. I'll just run down somebody till.
No, I've never heard that. We got political shows around here, and it gets nasty.
Well, I know it.
It's nice to listen to something that's soothing to the ears.
Bless your heart. You take care of yourself. Hope to talk to you soon.
Okay.
Bye-bye. 1-800-572-8255. You know, I told you a few minutes ago about all the big doings going on in Madison December the 6th and 7th, and we decided we'd get some more details on that. We're going to talk to our friend Marguerite Horton, Executive Director of the Madison Convention and Visitors Bureau. Good morning, young lady.
Good morning, Ludlow.
How you doing?
Just fine.
Y'all are winding up down there to do some fun stuff on the 6th and 7th. With these antebellum tours. Tell me a little bit more about that.
Well, this is our annual town and country holiday tour. We have it the first weekend in December every year. And this year, our theme is something special. Everything that's going to be seen on the tour was built prior to the Civil War. So we have townhouses and we have plantations, and they were all here before General Sherman came through and did his thing.
Yeah, and his thing was something else in that area, but he missed y'all. This is three separate private homes, right?
Three separate private home tours.
There's
a Saturday day tour from 10 to 4, and then we do a special candlelight tour from 5 till 9, and then Sunday afternoon from 1 till 5.
Tell me about the candlelight tour. That sounds wonderful.
Well, it really is. All of the homes that are opened during Saturday evening are lit by candlelight, and they'll all have the luminaries going up their walks, so they're real easy to find, and they're all right in town, so you can do the tour on foot, and we have 8 homes open that night, and it's going to be a beautiful evening.
I've been there, and you do it right. Yeah, I mean, I've been there for the
tour. We have a lot of fun.
Yeah. Now, there's a chance to save a little money here by buying the tickets early. Tell us about that.
Okay. We have special early buy tickets that if they are purchased before Sunday the 30th, this coming Sunday, the $20 ticket is $16. So you can save about 20% by giving us a call from now until Sunday and going ahead and ordering your ticket.
Give us a number where they can do that and save that $4.
Sure.
We're talking two cheeseburgers here, aren't you?
We're at 800-709-7406.
You must have one of the more fun jobs in the world, working right there in beautiful Madison and encouraging folks to come in there and enjoy what folks like the two of us kind of take for granted, the beautiful, beautiful Madison, Georgia.
We are very lucky. We're located right here on the square and can look at our big picture windows and see what's going on in town, you know. And we have our Welcome Center open 7 days a week and have a lot of folks that come to see us.
Okay, I'm going to try my best to get down to either the 6th or the 7th for one of these tours. I'm not sure what the schedule holds, but you might want to go ahead and buy my Christmas present early so you can have
it waiting for you.
Listen, the number is 1-800-709-7406. We've been talking about jump-starting your Christmas spirit, and this is probably the best way I know to do it. Go back and answer the telephone, my friend. We'll talk to you soon.
Mighty fine.
Thank you now.
Mm-hmm.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
1-800-57, it's a great place, and you're gonna love it. My hometown, as a matter of fact. 1-800-572-8255, Ludlow.
Always hanging above the bar. I want to thank you for this broken heart that I've got. Merry Christmas, girl, wherever in the world you are.
All right. Speaking of Madison, Georgia, Double R, King of the Slopes, is with us. Hello, Double R.
Well, good morning.
How you doing?
Doing great. How are you?
I am doing so good.
Well, listen, you're not going to believe what Jim's got me doing today.
Tell me.
Jim Small has got me at the Madison Airport today doing reports on how busy the airport is.
Oh, that's good. He wanted to get you out of the station, didn't he?
So far, I've seen a deer run across the runway.
Uh-huh.
And also, I've seen squirrels eating nuts on the runway this morning, too.
So what you're saying is not to worry about leaving from a big airport. Come to Madison.
There you go. Exactly. And also, we've got maybe one or two planes coming in every 6 hours.
Well, that's good. So
we are, you know, we're getting kind of busy here in the Madison area as far as air traffic.
Every 6 hours. That's amazing.
Yeah, every 6 hours. I figured you'd find that amazing there. So Jim thought...
Are you sending back reports to the news department?
I sure am, yes. If, you know, I'm sitting here, you know, twiddling my thumbs, and every now and then I'll pick up the phone and do a report for Jim, for, you know, how busy it is out here at the Madison Airport.
All right. Well, that's good.
I just hope I don't get run over by some of these planes out here.
Is it Madison International?
I was hoping maybe it would be today, but it doesn't seem to be too international today.
Is there a sign up anywhere?
There's a sign that says watch out for air traffic coming in today.
Uh-huh.
Especially for the next few days.
But they do call it Madison Airport.
They do call it Madison Airport.
Okay.
Matter of fact, the air traffic controller has got me running errands for him, getting him done it because he's, you know, because of all of the...
Because... He can't leave his post because there'll be another airplane in 4 or 5 hours.
Yeah, no.
Yeah, well, that's good.
Yeah, so, see, I'm having fun today.
Well, that's good. We call it a special assignment.
Yeah, exactly. There you go. It's a special assignment. Of course, some of the listeners may want to call and maybe try to get parking reservations before they come out here.
Mm-hmm. How many cars can you park out there on a busy day?
Right now, we've got two of them out here.
Okay, well, there's still a couple spaces left.
A couple of spaces left.
You might want to hurry on out there.
Exactly. But I'll check in and let you know later.
Yeah, let me know if it picks up as afternoon wears on.
Okay, gotcha.
I'll talk to you later.
Have a great day.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
Denny, how did he get this number? Telstar International Communications, gang, long distance for 10 cents a minute, home or business, no tricks ever. Let's go to Gadsden, Alabama, where my buddy Hugh is anchored in, standing by. Hello.
Standing by, doing that at the airport. Our airport's real busy, too, you know.
Yeah, another one, yeah.
Well, when we kick holiday season off, we get a ham and bacon about a week before Thanksgiving.
Mm-hmm.
Then we have folks over, you know, kin folks and all, and all week, you know, we've got, you know, stuff. And then we have turkey on Thanksgiving. Try to stay sober.
Oh, you have to do that because you got in-laws in town you hadn't seen in years.
Try to stay sober.
Yeah.
I was in there eating me a biscuit while ago, and I thought I heard you say you'd want some money, was going to win some money, and I thought I'd try to scrape up kin folks with you or something.
Well, yeah, it sounded like a pretty sure thing from the letter I got. It's something around $850,000 and a new car. So it sounds pretty positive to me. I'll let you know.
You know, down here, they got a lot of people don't believe in gambling.
Mm-hmm.
And I wonder if I won, say, $12 million in the Georgia lottery, and I gave some of these preachers down here some of that money, would they take it?
Well, I guess that'd vary from preacher to preacher, wouldn't it?
I don't know. But, you know, some of them are real adamant about, you know, gambling being wrong. I'm not just wondering if they would take, you know, that tainted money out.
Well, you ought to just try. Just run a little test.
Well, I will. As soon as I win the lottery, I'll...
Well, try it with $10 and see if you get any bites. You take care of your bad self.
All right, so I'm going to go eat some ham.
Go do it. I'll talk to you.
Bye-bye.
Let's go to Spartanburg and talk to Betty Ann on the radio. Hello, Betty Ann.
Hi, Mr. Porch.
How are you?
Fine.
Good.
I was wondering, you know, the topic for today is what reminds you of Christmas?
Yeah, what starts your Christmas spirit.
I love to listen to bells. If I hear bells, it just reminds me of Christmas.
Oh, good.
And I've got, I collect bells and stuff like that. I just love bells.
Yeah, how old are you?
11.
11. How many bells do you have?
About 34.
Wow. Wow. Well, you always know at least one present you're going to get for Christmas. Somebody's going to give you a bell. Yeah, you're right. Bells, I mentioned the Salvation Army folks ringing the bells out by the kettle outside the stores.
Mm-hmm.
And that helps me, too. That really kind of starts my year off, first one of those I see.
I always have to tell my mom, give some money. Mom.
There you go. There you go. Well, I hope you're going to have a big Christmas. You already out of school for Thanksgiving?
I had my appendix removed, so I haven't been in school for quite a few days.
Well, you feeling all right?
Yes, sir.
Good, good. You be good, and I'm really glad you called. I hope you'll call us again.
Okay, thank you.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
Hey, you can jumpstart your Christmas by seeing the Appalachian Lights at Birch Farm in Dawson County, Georgia. Yeah. 1-800-572-8255. It is one glorious day today. They can say what they want to about the rain coming. I don't believe it. I may get surprised, but it's beautiful today, and you never know there was a drop anywhere around. Birds are singing. It is absolutely gorgeous. Our number, 1-800-572-8255. That's 1-800-572-TALK, and we'd like to know what is on your mind today.
Merry Christmas, everyone!
All right, let us go now to Winder, Georgia, station WIMO, and talk to Verlin. Hello, Verlin.
Good morning, Ludlow.
How are you, old friend?
I'm doing just fine. About yourself?
Wide open.
Okay. Well, actually, Ludlow, I'm in Struggleville, outside of Winder.
Okay.
Winder is in the suburbs of Struggleville, Georgia.
Oh, I didn't know that.
Yes. I didn't know if you had ever heard from Struggleville or not.
Well, we had a call about Struggleville yesterday, as a matter of fact.
Did you?
Yeah.
Well, I'm right here in the heart of Struggleville. They are still struggling out here. Some of the people did not have the opportunity to go to school a few years ago, Ludlow.
Uh-huh.
But one guy out here, he did go in his brother's place one day.
Uh-huh.
And they are looking for a bank out here, as well as a post office.
All right.
And their mayor out here, he's a little bit hard to get a hold of because he does not have a telephone.
He has no phone with an unlisted number. I love that.
You're right. So he's struggling, too, because he says he cannot afford a telephone, so he just does without.
All right.
Struggleville is located on Highway 82, just outside of Winder, about 3 miles, and people have been coming from everywhere to visit this location out here, and they have a sign up out front, Ludlow, says that we don't have it, you don't need it.
What is the claim to fame for Struggleville? What is there to see, I guess, what I'm asking?
Well, there's an old country store, and it's a very old country store.
Uh-huh.
And it has stuff in it that's probably been here for as long as the store's been here, about 50 years. And, you know, it's just a location here, and a lot of people live around here in this location, and they're just struggling for life.
All right. Well, I got to come up here and see some of that one of these days.
They welcome you to Struggleville, and there's one guy that around here. He has never, he cannot afford to get married, Ludlow, because he's been to a lot of weddings in his life, but he has never been to his own.
Uh-huh.
That's what's happening here in Struggleville, Georgia.
We thank you, Brother Verlin, for your update.
Thank you, Ludlow. Thanksgiving.
Take care, old friend.
Okay, bye-bye.
1-800-572-8255. More from Struggleville at a future date. Ashley in Spartanburg, South Carolina. Hello, Ashley.
Hey, Ludlow, how you doing this morning?
I'm doing good, bud. You all right?
I'm doing well.
Good.
Ludlow, I was riding down the road here, and I noticed some of these old oak trees just loaded down with mistletoe.
Yeah, big year for mistletoe, is it?
Yes, it is.
Yeah.
I believe I'm going to get out there on Thanksgiving Day with my .22, see if I can't shoot some down and get a little sugar.
I bet you can.
Okay. I just wanted to tell you, that reminds me of Chris. I love getting out there on Thanksgiving Day with a .22.
Yeah.
And shooting some of that down, giving it to family and friends.
Isn't mistletoe, when you see it in the house, isn't that one of the things that really helps you get started into the holidays?
It really is.
Yeah.
It really is. None of that old plastic junk.
No, got to have the real thing, yeah. All right, buddy, take care.
You have a good day.
All right, talk to you soon.
All right, thank you now.
Let's talk to the Choo Choo Man, Dallas, Georgia, on the radio. Hello, Choo.
Hello, Ludlow.
How you doing?
Well, I do pretty good.
Good.
Yeah. Buddy?
Yeah.
The guy with his hand up said he was losing some leaves.
Yeah, thinks his trees are dying.
Well, tell him not to worry about that, Luddy, because I got enough out of my gutters yesterday to fertilize a 40-acre farm.
All right. Y'all need to get together.
I know. I've got a few on the ground, yeah, too.
Uh-huh.
And I can't find my rake.
How hard have you tried to find that rake?
Not too hard. Oh. Well, I start my Thanksgiving, my holidays off every year with the biggest turkey I can find. Yeah, I start listening to all these shows that are giving turkeys away.
Yeah, a lot of radio shows do that.
Yeah, and I enjoy that.
Mm-hmm.
And one or two years, I have won a turkey.
All right.
Yeah, I won a smoked turkey one year.
Those are good.
That thing was good.
Yeah, those are good.
Yeah.
We talked to Pennsylvania Vince earlier. He won a ham.
Yeah, well, I've won a ham,
yeah,
too.
Uh-huh.
And I tell you what, I won a nice ham one year. I mean, one of them $50 hams.
What did you have to do to win it?
Gosh, I forgot.
I tell you what, I bet it was. I bet you had to gobble like a turkey.
No. I wouldn't have ever got it if I'd had to do that.
That's the way Vince won his.
Because, you know, well, Vince could do that,
yeah,
but I don't know how.
Yeah.
Yeah, you know, Vince is in the music biz.
Yeah.
I guess that's what taught him how to gobble like a turkey.
A trained turkey gobbler.
Well, yeah, I don't have Christmas carols on my machine, you know. Somebody asked you if I had that,
yeah,
Christmas carol going like a train.
Mm-hmm.
No, I don't have that, Luddy. I just got the old Pan American.
The old whistle.
Yeah. The real whistle off the Pan American.
Wow.
Yeah, and it was done in 1946 in Nashville as it went by the Nashville Tower. And I'm hanging on to that.
Yeah, that's a keepsake, especially for a guy who grew up in the railroad business.
Man, I like that.
Yeah, yeah.
All right, that's about the way I start mine
every
year.
All right, time to get that turkey on now. Don't fool around here too long.
Yeah, I like that giblet gravy, too.
All right.
And you know, I kind of make...
You sound like a man maybe off your diet.
And well, I try to get off of it just a little bit every year, you know, about, yeah, Thanksgiving.
It's tough.
Busy Joe has to watch me close.
She's been doing that a long time.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, you know what, Luddy?
What?
A brick column won't move, will it, when you run into it?
No, not generally speaking.
Well,
no.
I've been told, you know, all your life you've heard, you know, it's like running into a brick wall.
Yeah.
I didn't believe that. I tried it yesterday.
Work out all right for you?
Yeah, while I was cleaning the gutter.
Uh-huh.
I went around the corner of the house, and Betty Jo moved the car. She pulled it under the carport a little farther than she'd been pulling it under.
Uh-huh.
And I caught the back of the car with my hand, and I was going to walk around the corner of the house, you know?
Yeah.
And I met that brick column face on.
Oh, Lord. Are you all right?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, but I snuck on around, you know. She didn't want me cleaning the gutters anyway. And I snuck on around there and got on the ladder.
Uh-huh.
And she looked out the back the kitchen window and saw me on the ladder. And she went to holler and said, "You get in this house, you're bleeding to death." I said, "What?" She said, "Blood done run from to your chin."
You take care of yourself. Go. I'll talk to you, my
friend. I'll try, buddy.
All right, buddy.
All right, bye-bye.
1-800-572-8255. Right.
I've been making plans for a season filled with cheer. I've got my round trip ticket, and I can't wait to make it home this year.
Georgia, and Donnie on the radio. Hello, Donnie.
Hey.
How are you, pal?
Pretty good. Well, actually, I'm sitting on the outskirts of Struggleville. Feeding my cows.
we hit the jackpot on Struggleville.
Yeah, I'm telling you. I just heard Berlin a while ago. I just was coming on the way over here with a bale of hay, and I saw something that reminded me of when I was a kid at Christmas, and I just died laughing. I was just hilarious. You know, when I was a kid, like most of us, listened to your program, didn't have a whole lot and all, and most of what we had to play with was the farm animals.
Yeah.
Dogs and the pigs, and you know, you try to get a baby pig out and the old mama get after you, you know, and you want to go out and you and the dogs want to go out and see the colts and the mares run you off and all. Well, I'm coming down the road over here, and there's a farm over here. It's got emus and ostriches and llamas and goats and just all this menagerie of stuff, you know.
Mm-hmm.
And these three young boys, I look like maybe 10, 12 years old. I just come around the curve in time. I saw this in a dead run for the fence. And this emu, this giant emu, is right on their tail. And they got to the fence. Two of them goes over. One goes through it. And the emu's trying to get over the fence to get to them. And it just reminded me so much when I was a kid, you know, like I say, you know, the old brood mares always run you off, and the mama cows would run you off over their babies, and the mama, the hog tried to run you off with the baby pig.
You got to wonder what they did to that bird, didn't you?
Yeah, really. Well, one of them took the stick, so I don't know.
Yeah.
But it was hilarious. I mean, it's one of those situations you had to have been there, you'd appreciate it.
Oh, that's funny. That is funny.
But
I love it.
But it's kind of, you know, like I say, you know, even at Christmas, if you got any kind of toys, it was outside to play with toys.
Yeah.
You know, bow and arrows or trucks or... And it's just good to see the kids outside playing. You don't see that much anymore.
No, you really don't. And particularly when there's something as interesting as an emu chasing them. And I just wonder what that bird would have done to him if he'd have caught him.
Oh, yeah, really. I don't know.
Yeah.
They got some pretty strong legs.
I would think so. I'd want to go slow one of those bad boys.
I'm telling you.
All right, buddy, you take care of yourself.
You bet.
Good to talk to you.
You bet, boy.
1-800-572-8255 is our number. It's the Aller Pure Air Filter, brought to you by the wonderful folks from Allergy Free. Our number, 1-800-572-8255. Let us go to Cleveland, Tennessee, and talk to Priscilla. Hello, young lady.
Chestnuts roasting on an open fire, Jack Frost nipping at your nose, Yuletide carols being sung by the choir, and folks dressed up like Eskimos. I'm in the Christmas spirit.
You sound like you have jump started your Christmas spirit.
Hey, I've been in it for 3 weeks.
Good.
I have. I got my tape out, slipped it in the tape player, and I've been singing. I call my friends. I leave them a Christmas song.
I get requests now. They call and go, you haven't called me lately and left me any Christmas music. I'll be there. I'll be calling this week, okay?
That's great.
Yeah.
That's great.
Well, it sounds like you're in a really good mood today.
In a great mood.
Yeah, you've just really been funny. Funny. Hey, what about Choo-Choo? Didn't he say that his wife raised her own turkey and that he had to chase it down on Thanksgiving?
He mentioned that at one time some time back. Yes, he did.
Yeah, and well, I was looking for, he was going to call like tomorrow and tell us about how bad it was about chasing the turkey down and all the stuff.
Well, we'll hear from him. He's faithful.
Well, I hope so.
Yeah.
I don't want to miss that. You were talking about the sweepstakes and winning millions of dollars and everything. My baby got something in the mail last week for winning a couple of million.
Oh, good.
Yeah. He happened to take out a subscription for one of the magazines and everything, and so he gets this mail, and he's like, Mom, look, you know, I can win millions of dollars. I said, Son, sit down. We need to have a talk.
Lots of luck. Let me tell you about the facts of life. Yeah.
Right. Anyway, let me see. There was something else. Okay. I think that's about all.
All right.
Hey, one more tiny little thing.
Yeah.
In our church family, oh, yeah, I know. Last night, I was at church last night, and someone, as we were leaving, they say, don't eat too much on Thanksgiving. I'm like, hey, don't tell me that.
That's right. Bad advice.
This is a premeditated eating session. I've been thinking about it for some time. I'm going to do it.
Exactly right. Bad advice. Bad advice. You
yes.
Be sweet. I'll talk to you.
Thank you.
Bye-bye. Let us talk to the incredibly British Bridget right here on the radio. Hello, beautiful lady.
And how are you? Thank you for coming.
Great. Great.
Talking about Thanksgiving, listening to Choo Choo a moment ago, I just about lost my teeth.
Mm-hmm. Cleaning out the gutters.
Yes, but walking into the colu. God love him. As long as he didn't apologize to it.
I bet the first thing he said was, excuse me, what do you
mean? How many of us have done that?
I have.
I can hear Denny laughing in the background.
Yeah, absolutely.
Oh, Lord have mercy.
Well, what's going to start your Christmas spirit, Bridget?
I think it already did. That
good.
Young lady singing like that, she's got a lovely voice.
A very nice voice.
Hasn't she?
Very nice voice.
God. Yes, I wish I had a voice like that.
Wanda, you got one of those great English voices where...
It's better speaking, darling, than it is singing.
Well, I guess that may be true, but the nice thing about it is you sound like you know more than we do.
As a friend of mine that lives up in Ella J says, not hardly.
Yeah, that's the nice thing. How could anybody ever disagree with Winston Churchill? It was like the voice coming down from the mountaintop when he said.
You know, I was thinking about him this morning, and you know, because this time of year it's his birthday as well, and. What a great voice he had. What a great mind, you know.
Oh, boy.
Wasn't he a wonderful, wonderful character? He really was.
Oh, one of my absolute favorites.
Yes.
One of my absolute
yes.
favorites. I like
that. Did I ever tell you about the time that this was during the Second World War?
We got 30 seconds.
Okay, quickly.
Okay.
During the Second World War, when clothing was extremely hard to come by, my grandfather decided he needed a new hat. Well, he didn't have the coupons, and nobody in the stores was willing to let him have a hat without the coupons. Or coupons,
yeah.
As we said in England.
These were rationing.
Yes. So he wrote to the Winston Churchill, who was Prime Minister at that time, and complained about it, and asked Winston Churchill if he'd be willing to donate one of his old hats. Well, back comes a reply apologizing profusely, but owing to the clothing shortage, etc. He was having to hang on to all of his hats.
but he got the letter, at least. I got to run, sweetness. You be good. I'll talk to you.
Okay. Bye-bye.
Hang in there.
Yeah.
1-800-572-8255. Surefire way. Kick off that Christmas spirit. Appalachian Lights at Birch Farm. Over 500,000 lights there. You can see them in your car. You can drive right through and see all these animated scenes. Beautiful lights. Really in the Christmas spirit the way it should be. You need to take somebody up there to see this, and you know who I'm talking about, and you can also take a hayride through there. More information and directions, call 1-800-600-BURT. 1-800-600-BURT, and tell them Ludlow told you to call. I want to tell you a few facts about my friends at Telstar International. No promises, just... It's a great day to be alive. LaGrange, Georgia, and Pat on the radio. Hello, Pat.
Hello, Ludlow. How are you?
I'm great. How you doing?
Pretty good myself. I was just enjoying listening to British Bridget speak because I'm getting to go to London Friday myself.
Oh, good for you.
I'm just looking forward to it.
How long are you going to get to be there?
Through the 7th of December. We'll take a side trip to Paris one day, so it's just real exciting.
All right, now when you... I'm going in April, so So I want you to call me back when you get back and get rested and everything and unpacked and let me know what I need to put on my list to be sure and see.
Oh, love it.
And I want to know how you like Paris.
Oh, yeah, mostly I'm claustrophobic, so going through the channel may be an experience for me.
Well, I think it's probably big enough where it's not going to bother you. I hope.
Well, anyway, about your topic today about what makes Christmas, it has to be Christmas music. I'm really a Christmas junkie for every bit of it, including getting involved with all the crowds. And I mean, every bit of it. I have to hear Christmas music all the month of December, all day, every day. I never get sick of it. And in the middle of it, of course, what's most exciting is watch how the children respond to all that.
Yeah, that's the ticket.
Oh, it's so much fun.
That
to watch
is the
and
ticket.
Get so
yeah.
excited. And of course, it brings back a ton of memories of Christmas past.
Yeah, and you know what? That is a big, big part of it, too.
Oh, yeah.
The memories, yeah.
Oh, yeah. Especially the ones that are no longer with us.
Yep.
But anyway, enjoying the show as always, and I'll let you know something when I get back.
You have a good, safe trip.
Thank you.
Talk to you.
Uh-huh.
Bye-bye.
Uh-huh.
Dynamite is here. Hello there, beautiful lady.
Well, thank you, Ludlow. Good morning.
How you doing?
Well, I'm doing great.
Good.
I start my holiday off with a birthday. My birthday was yesterday, and I wanted to talk with you, and I couldn't get through.
Well, happy birthday a little late.
Well, thank you, and it really was a good day, too.
Good.
Got to be with my grandson. You know, I don't even have any children. I got grandchildren.
Uh-huh.
And it was really special. He was in a lovable mood, and it was neat.
Oh, that is good.
But anyway, getting to see you kind of helped, too.
It was fun. I enjoyed it. Didn't get to visit as much as I'd like to, but it was fun.
Yeah, I appreciate what you did, too. But anyway, and I won't go into that.
Yeah.
But anyhow, I'm just starting to get excited now. We're going to get to be with some of my husband's family tomorrow. And I don't know what we're going to do for Christmas, but, you know, I want to hear all the pretty music. And
well, you get to start planning what you're going to do for Christmas.
Oh, yeah. Believe it or not, I've got all my stuff wrapped and ready to go.
I'm so proud of you.
I mean, I can't believe I've done that.
I am so proud of you.
Bought and paid for and everything. I mean, good gracious.
Wrapped and ready to rumble.
Yeah, that's unusual for me. I try to have it bought, but not wrapped.
You take care of your sweet self.
All right, you too.
Talk to
have
you
a
soon.
Holiday.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Frosty Moat Mountain, pure spring water. Water from the spring, not the tap. It's available at fine stores everywhere.
960. The new WRFC, Athens, a Southern Broadcasting Company's radio station.
You're up. Winchester, Georgia, and my buddy the Bumpkin. Hello there, Bumpkin.
Good morning, Mr. Luddy. How you doing this morning?
Good, buddy. Good.
It's a beautiful day in the neighborhood.
Eh? Wonderful. It is.
It was absolutely beautiful. Look, I want to tell you three things.
All right.
I want to tell the man how to cook his turkey now that was on there a few minutes ago.
Yeah, I hope he's still listening.
All right. First, I want to wish you a happy Thanksgiving and all the fun seekers out there all over.
Thank you, buddy.
And I want to tell the man how to cook the turkey. You need to get a pot that you can completely submerge the turkey in some good peanut oil.
Right big pot.
Right big pot. You need to submerge the turkey. Get it to 375 degrees before you put your turkey in there. Get you a coat hanger and tie around his pussies so you can get him back out.
Yeah.
I cook him for 3.5 minutes per pan. And try to keep that, to get your wife's kidney thermometer, and try to keep that thing at 300, as close to 375 as you can. And you have some good eating.
All right.
And, Mr. Luddy, I enjoy your show very much, and we'll see you later.
Buddy, you have a big turkey day.
You too.
Talk to you soon. Bye-bye. Bulldog Betty is right here. At my fingertips. Hello there, beautiful lady.
Good morning, good morning. This is Illustrious Potentate, I take it.
It is for a fact.
Certainly good seeing you and the tall person the other day.
It was fun. Short visit, but a good
yes.
one.
Yes. Well, you know, you measure quality. You don't measure quantity.
That's right.
Somebody said that. I can't remember who, but I'm sure somebody must have.
Mm-hmm.
Just checking on the fettle this morning. I guess it's got a little giblet gravy splattered on it.
I would like to say it's fine.
That's good. I have heard that recipe that man just gave, I have heard that you have not eaten turkey until you have tried the deep fried like that.
You know, it's very good. If that was the only way I could ever have it, I wouldn't want it.
No, but I don't think I would either.
As an if on occasion, it's good.
We will next. Well, of course, this is an open invitation. What you do is you cook one about 20 pounds or whatever, and then you just say, "Everybody, come up. We're gonna have French fried turkey today."
Yeah.
Uh huh.
Well, we could do that.
We could, but we're not likely to. Don't know a great deal of interest. The world's two most perfect grandsons have brought their parents down for a short visit, and that always kicks off the Christmas season for us because they come home for Thanksgiving, then, as they should, they have Christmas at their house.
Right, right.
And they straighten out all the world, tell their grandparents all the things that, you know, they discover that we're doing wrong or should be doing differently and this sort of thing. So it just sort of starts the season off.
You know when it's here. When the front door bell rings.
Well, it doesn't ring. It just sort of explodes, as it were.
Yeah.
But I have decided that there is another degree that probably needs to be conferred on Coach Donovan, if it hasn't been already. The man is obviously a master psychologist.
Mm-hmm.
Did you hear what he did after the debacle of the week before, which we're all still trying to ignore, what he did before those pluck boys crawled on that plane to go to Oxford last weekend?
What?
Sat every last one of them down and made them sit through watching the film of the Ole Miss game the year before. You and I both remember they were about, losing 30 to nothing or something like that at the half, and decided they wouldn't play the second half of the game, and Ole Miss came from behind and beat the socks off.
A little memory jogger there.
I thought that was beautiful.
I like it. I like it. You got to go there to play the whole game.
That's right. You just don't play 30 minutes.
That's right.
But the man obviously is... besides being a fine American and a credit to his mom and daddy, which we know he is.
Of course.
He's got his psychology pretty well in order, too, I would say.
Well, are you going to be in front of the television tomorrow?
No, you mean tomorrow or Saturday?
I mean, I'm Saturday, excuse me. Boy, am I rushing the weekend or what?
Does
Saturday.
Hope work on Sunday?
Yeah, I knew you'd be right there with the popcorn waiting.
Yes, and a big knife ready to start out fracking if they don't do what light out for downtown with my picket sign if they embarrass the family.
We'll have a happy conversation about this next week.
You better believe it. You folks have the happiest Thanksgiving ever. And as you say, we are hoping and expecting great things on Saturday, and we'll talk to you next week.
All right, my love. Take care.
You too.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Our number, 1-800-572-8255. We'll be right back. I want you to put down April 23rd to May 2nd on your calendar. Yes, sirree, because I'm going to take a group of the Wackos to England and Scotland and we're going to have the time of our lives. First class all the way. We're going to see Scotland the way it was meant to be seen. Once you're on board, you call 1-800-906-4232. That's 1-800-906-4232. We're going to England and Scotland.
Sports Talk 960.
Boom, diggy, 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 boom, diggy, bop.
Joining us from Baseball Weekly is the editor, Paul White. Paul, how are you this afternoon?
Doing great, guys.
Why do you think the Braves would have not wanted to re-sign Blauzer? He had a great season, and we were talking earlier, it doesn't seem like money would be a factor considering, you know, Ted Turner's their owner, and the guy can give $1 billion to the UN. I mean, obviously you could pay a guy like Blauzer.
Sports Talk 960 on News Radio 960, the new WRFC.
Welcome to Winterfest, a fun-filled Bavarian mountain holiday in beautiful Helen, Georgia. Hike our winding, wooded trails, take in the majestic views of our sparkling, clear waterfalls. Tour arts and craft shops, view artists and potters at work, and other backroad treasures. Include plenty of time to explore this magnificent area where history and beauty come alive. For your picture book holiday, call 1-800-858-8027. Alpine Helen, the happy place in Georgia.
So heavy topics here, gang, just fun conversation. I'm Ludlow Porch. Join me weekdays 10 to noon on News Radio 960, the new WRFC. A Homer in Knoxville. Hello, Homer.
Good morning, Ludlow, and happy Thanksgiving.
And to you, buddy.
Bulldogs really flying the colors, ain't they?
Always. Year round?
Yeah.
Always.
Mark Twain made a remark one time late in the 1800s during the innovation of plumbing, and that was during the same period that the Fiji Islanders were yet cannibals.
Mm-hmm.
And obviously Mark, or Samuel, saluted the British soldiers.
Wow.
On that very day, with just a few hundred men there, three Victoria Crosses were rewarded to the British soldiers.
All right.
So gallant had they been. And that's equivalent to our Medal of Honor.
Exactly right. Exactly right. All right, big boy, got to run. Thank you.
Thank you.
Take care. 1-800-572-8255. The cleaning woman from Cleveland. Hello there. How you doing?
Good morning to you, Ludlow.
Good morning to you, my love.
I'm doing very well, thank you.
Good.
And not to burst your bubble, but it's cloudy in Cleveland, and you know what that
well,
means.
Well, it's starting to cloud up here, too.
Yeah. Talking about how beautiful it was, but the temperature's nice. And I'm glad, because I'm going to use this afternoon and tomorrow afternoon to mow my leaves.
Oh, yeah.
So, you know, I'm going to mulch them up
uh-huh.
instead of raking them, because I don't like to rake.
Good for you.
As far as what gets me kind of, I hate to say it, and as up as I am about everything else, I'm not really a holiday person. I don't get into what you might call the Christmas spirit and stuff, and I never have. I don't know why.
You never get into it?
No. I'm not a Scrooge or anything, but I'm just not, I don't know, like I'm not one of these manic shoppers, and I don't decorate to speak of. I hang up Christmas cards as they come. And that's what I was going to say. What really kind of starts my holiday spirit, what there is of it, is when I start getting my Christmas cards in the mail from people.
Yeah, me too.
You know? And I start hanging those around the doorways and up the stairway and that kind of thing. But I'm just not a big... the only thing I do is I love Christmas music. And I don't just play it in December. I play it all year long. I have tapes in my car of Christmas music.
Oh, that's a nice touch. I to be honest... I am ready for the Christmas music to move along when it's over. Normally I've just about had it.
I don't do that constantly. I'm not trying to say that. You know, I switch around a lot, and I rotate my tapes and stuff all the time. But I always keep at least one Christmas tape of some kind in there. And
that's a nice thought. I like
Carpenters
that.
I love. And this is the beginning of my annual one-woman crusade against glitter.
Yeah.
I just want everybody out there, if you're even considering buying Christmas balls for the trees, cards, or anything else that has glitter on it, let me just beg you, don't.
To open a Christmas card and get glitter all in your lap is an awful thing.
It gets in your hair. It gets in the furniture. It gets in the dog. On the dog. When I say in, I mean down next to the skin.
Yeah,
you can't get it off. And I mean, I'm cleaning that stuff in May and June. I'm not joking about that.
Oh, I know
it's insidious.
I know it.
Well, I don't know if I have time now. I was going to tell you a quick funny thing that happened to me in the line at Walmart the other day, but I can save it if we're short.
You got a minute.
Okay. I was just minding my business, standing in line behind a lady, and somebody else, for some reason, there was a delay. So, but it was busy, 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 and they were saying, I wonder what happened. You know, must have been somebody called for snow or something. There's a lot of people in here. And she said, well, you know, remember that blizzard and all the power went off and everything? I think I need to get myself an electric blanket in case that happens again. And I looked at her, and I didn't say anything. I just shook my head. And I thought to myself, yeah, that's going to do you a whole lot of good when the power's out for 5 days. That electric blanket,
That's
anyway,
funny. You have a great holiday.
I will plan on it. We're going out to breakfast, actually. How's that for a tradition?
Going where?
To breakfast.
That's good.
Yeah, going to Shoney's.
All right.
Yeah, last year we went to Cracker Barrel. We rotate.
You be sweet. I'll talk to you.
Better than cooking.
Yeah.
Okay, I'll talk to you.
So take care.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. 1-800-572-8255. You heard us talking a few minutes ago about the Town and Country Tour presenting an antebellum Christmas Saturday and Sunday, December 6th and 7th in beautiful Madison, Georgia. All the residences that you will see down there were built prior to the Civil War. And you can save some money. These if you call right away, $16 per person for this tour. If you wait till the day of the tour, you're going to have to pay $20. So here's a number for you to call and to make your reservations and let them get your tickets ready. 1-800-709-7406. 1-800-709-7406. And I promise you, this wonderful tour of homes will jumpstart your holiday season. 1-800-709-7406. See beautiful Madison, Georgia, the way it should be seen.
John Blakely Winnebago in Douglasville, Georgia is America's number one Winnebago retailer for 1997. John Blakely has the largest selection of Winnebagos in the U.S. Choose from the all-new Chieftain, the redesigned Adventure, the Brave, Grand Tour, Luxor, Rialto, Mini, and Mini Winnie. The 1998 Brave SC from $39,995 or as little as $379 per month. John Blakely Winnebago in Douglasville, Georgia. Call toll-free 1-888-527-8287.
Courtyard by Marriott takes you inside our honeymoon suite.
To us, because the most valuable thing a man can have in this world is
the Grayson account.
At Courtyard, our honeymoon suite is for people who are married to their jobs or just living with them.
You're the man.
Courtyard, the hotel designed by business travelers. For reservations, call your travel agent or 800-321-2211.
News Radio 960, the new WRFC, gives you the latest information every 30 minutes with updates from Athens' largest broadcast news team. Extensive coverage of events that affect you most. In Athens, Northeast Georgia, the nation and the world.
Here's reporter Mark Aylwine of ABC affiliate WRFC, Athens, Georgia.
Police are continuing their investigation and
your charges for reliable, frequent, informative news, weather, and sports. News Radio 960, the new WRFC.
Hi, this is Ludlow Porch, and you're listening to the new WRFC, and that tickles me nearly about to death. Georgia and Peter. Peter, it's a sin and a shame to interrupt that music, isn't it?
It sure is.
Well, it's gorgeous. How you doing, bud?
Good. Happy Thanksgiving.
Thank you.
Remind everybody out there that first Thanksgiving was actually in Jamestown, not up there in the Northeast in Massachusetts.
A little history tip of the day.
Yes. A funny turkey story, which I may have told you, but I think it bears repeating.
All right.
A young girl brought a turkey to see me one day in the deepest trunk I've ever seen. Turkey was in the back. She said, turkey has come up lame.
I mean, tell everybody, you're a vet.
Yes.
Okay.
And this is a pet turkey.
A sick pet turkey.
Yes. She said, he's come up lame, and I don't know what to do. She said, I think he got hit by a car. He chases cars. Now, you got to understand that a turkey with a broken leg is a one-legged turkey.
Yeah.
Well, anyway, so I wrapped my arms around this 40-pound beast and hoisted him out of this trunk and did find a fracture midway down his leg. And I had done work, vaccinated dogs for this girl before and done some other stuff. So we were pretty good friends. And I looked at her, and she brought him in, I guess, about, it was a little earlier in November, but it was in November. And I looked at her and I said, has he got any plans for Thanksgiving? Didn't go over too well.
And you got that blank look.
Yeah, a very blank look. I was glad she didn't have any weapons. We went on to try to fasten a splint. I'm not sure how the turkey did, because, like, you know, he's got two legs and he has to support 40 pounds
on
two legs, and it's very difficult for the, just due to the pain, to get him to last long enough to heal.
Yeah.
Another funny thing, my wife and I noticed on a cooking channel, I think it was last night, it might have been the night before, they were talking about proper ways to thaw a turkey. And the show said you need to put it in the refrigerator and thaw for 4 days per pound bird. And I looked at her and I said, well, you know, if you start now, it'll be ready for Valentine's Day.
Oh, that's funny. That's
I don't
funny.
Know what they meant, for whether it was for 4 days or whether it was for 4 hours per pound.
Or how much of the instructions they got filed up.
Well, that's a good way to put it, because turkey is... But anyway, we won't go there.
Yeah.
I just thought, I hope people think before they follow this thing, because he spoiled a long time before he gets defrosted.
Yeah, yeah, you will know. You will know when he's not ready, when he's no longer ready.
That's right.
Well, what are y'all having? Are y'all ham people or turkey people or both?
We're turkey people.
Yeah.
And
traditionalist.
Yeah. Although ham's wonderful.
Yeah.
And they both make excellent leftovers.
Yeah, the only reason that I lean toward the ham is because I know I'm going to eat it for a couple of days.
Yeah.
And it makes better sandwiches, at least. I think
that's true. But we usually eat everything. And my wife makes a delicious turkey and chicken and seafood casserole. She uses the same ingredients, just varies the meat.
Mm-hmm.
And so what's left over goes in the casserole.
Hardly recognize it.
Well, I tell you what, it is good eating.
All right. I'm glad you called, old Fred. You have a safe and a great one.
Thank you, Ludlow.
Talk to you soon.
Okay.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Let's go to Faye in Waverly, Georgia. Hello, Faye.
Hi, Ludlow.
How are you?
Oh, pretty good.
Good. What's on your mind?
Well, I called to tell you about Christmas.
All right.
Of course, I always decorate inside and out. Everything's ready at my house by Thanksgiving Day. And then after we have dinner, you know, we turn on the lights and we have packages under the tree and everything. We light a Yule log.
Oh, you've got, you do your tree on Thanksgiving Day, too?
Oh, yeah, I light it after the supper.
Oh, okay.
And Thanksgiving's over, then we turn on the outside lights and the lights inside. I decorate the whole house.
All right, makes it official then.
Yeah, and that starts the season. But what I try to teach the kids is that Christmas is about Jesus. And it's also about Santa, because, you know, there's a thing the Methodists have out that Jesus was born and the kings brought the gifts to Jesus to show love and to give homage to him, because
mm-hmm.
he was the king. And Santa Claus is also love. He's something that eventually leaves us. Well, never in our hearts, but...
Yeah, if you can, and it doesn't take too much effort, you can by your actions and what you're doing, you can let the children know that this is primarily a religious holiday. You can do that. A lot of folks have problems with that, but you can really do that. Listen, I got to get out of here. You be sweet. I'll talk to you soon. More conversation right after this.
classic city tradition for nearly 50 years. This is News Radio 960, the new WRFC, Athens.
Good morning. I'm Indra Sybil with an information update on News Radio 960, the new WRFC. It's a sunny 54 degrees at 11:30. The official three-day forecast is coming up. Hartsfield Atlanta International Airport is preparing for a crush of holiday travelers today as the Thanksgiving holiday begins. Airport officials are expecting 200,000 people to travel through the hub today. And previous estimates of the number of people infected with the AIDS virus may not have been high enough. In a new report today, the UN says more than 30 million people around the world are living with the virus. WRFC Business News, the Dow is down around 3 points, the NASDAQ up 4 points. News Radio 960, WRFC News Time, 11:31.
Listen closely. These are the sounds some of our patients experience on the weekend. And these are the sounds experienced by some of our biggest and repeat patients on the weekend. At MMR's open-sided MRI facilities, we realize you don't have to end up under tons of professional football players to need our services. But if you do, we're here to serve you. If your doctor says you need an MRI, remember, you have choices. The older MRIs were tunnel-like tubes your whole body was placed in. Even if you're not claustrophobic, you often become claustrophobic. Not a problem. In and out in about an hour in a non-hospital atmosphere. MMR's open-sided MRI facility serving professional athletes and their fans. Call 1-800-890-OPEN for the center nearest you. That's 1-800-890-OPEN.
More Ludlow Porch coming up, but first the official three-day forecast from WRFC meteorologist Kathy Francis.
A nice day coming up today. We'll have sunshine for the most part. It'll be breezy, fairly mild this afternoon. Today's high about 64. Overnight, partly cloudy, low not far from 40. For Thanksgiving Day tomorrow, plenty of sunshine and warm, high 66. And on Friday, times of clouds and sunshine and warm, Friday's high 68. This is meteorologist Kathy Francis with the official three-day forecast on News Radio 960, the new WRFC.
Right now, 54 and sunshine here on South Village Avenue in Athens. I'm Indra Sybil, and you're up to date at 11:33. More news in less than 30 minutes and bulletins at once from News Radio 960, the new WRFC.
All right. Dexter, Georgia, and Ted, alive and well. Hello, Ted. How you doing?
I'm doing fine.
Good. Everything okay in gorgeous Dexter?
Yeah. We ready for Turkey Day down here at the Streak Link, Casino and Golf Resort, Highway 22.
Y'all going to have a special buffet type thing?
Well, yeah, we got a spread that just the beat all spreads. I mean, you name it, and we got it
all
down
right
here at the Link.
All right.
Ludlow, before we go any further, I need to put to rest a rumor real quick, like.
All right.
You know, I understand yesterday y'all was talking about billboards,
mm-hmm.
and there are some choice billboards down 75 here.
Mm-hmm.
There is no truth to the rumor that Ted has financed the Peak-a-Lean adult nightclub.
I wouldn't have believed that.
So if you see a big billboard on the side of the road advertising the Peak-a-Lean,
yeah.
I ain't got nothing to do with
okay,
it.
Okay, I believe that.
All right.
I believe that.
And as far as glitter goes,
yeah.
I need to get the cleaning lady down here because, Lord, we got our share of glitter. Dolene loves glitter. We got glitter on the ceiling, and every time somebody wins big, Dolene goes running through the casino scattering like a little fairy or cherub scattering glitter everywhere.
Pretty repulsive behavior for a grown woman, isn't
yeah,
it?
Yeah. You know, I've been wanting to invite Rendezvous down here. You know, we got a mall that we're opening that's going to connect the main part of the casino to our new Sushi Land Hotel.
Yeah.
And I was thinking about inviting Ron to come open a muffin shop down here, but you know how he loves to skip, and he'd probably go skipping through here scattering glitter, too. So.
Yeah, you couldn't have both of them doing that.
Yeah, but I just wonder, you know, I heard the cleaning lady. I was hoping I could have got on before she did because I wanted to make a proposition to her, see if she wanted to come down here and be our in charge of cleaning this casino. You know, this 3,000 rooms we got down here, it takes a load.
Glitter management.
Glitter management.
Yeah, that'd be her title.
Yeah, but... Anyway, I asked Denny if y'all got your dozen turkeys I sent y'all, and he said he ain't seen them yet.
Not one.
So I don't know. They were stuffed with $1,000 bills. He said something about the girl out there at the front desk who disappeared a couple of days ago. So. She
No telling you.
She's going to have a very nice Christmas.
Yeah, yeah. And that fella that is the veterinarian that called up here a minute ago.
Yeah, Peter, yeah.
Yeah, I was talking about that. He's on the cooking channel there about that turkey.
Mm-hmm.
Boy, I tell you what, 4 days per pound, that'd be some nasty bird, wouldn't it? Woo!
You got to wonder how many telephone calls old folks got about that.
I'll tell you what, by the time you pull that out of the oven, you'd have to file an environmental impact statement, you know what I mean? Well, Luddy, I got to get back to count my money. I just wanted to wish you and yours a happy Thanksgiving and tell everybody to come see us at the lean. In fact, we got a special going down here Thanksgiving afternoon. The first 100 people that walk through the door and say they listen to Luddy, they get a free turkey leg and $50 worth of silver dollars for the slots.
I don't know how anybody could ask for more than that.
What, all they got to do is get in the car, find us on the map. When you find us on the map, there we are. Come see us.
On your map and in your heart.
There you go.
All right, buddy. You take care of yourself.
Take care. Bye.
See you soon.
All right. Bye.
Bye-bye. Let's talk to Noble in Ootowa, Tennessee. Hello, Noble.
Hey there. Good morning.
How are you, old friend?
Oh, fine. Thank you. Listen, on that call that you had just a few calls back about the Imperial War Museum.
Yeah.
I just had opened a publication here, the newsletter from the American Air Museum News, and I didn't hear the caller mention anything about any American history there, but I was stationed at that Duxford Aerodrome 3 years during World War II, and they have just opened a new American Air Museum there. It was opened August 1, and they said it was the biggest royal occasion ever in the history of the Imperial War Museum. Well, now, this is separate. It's another museum there.
Yeah.
And the Queen was there, and they had a flyby by the B-17 Fortress, P-51 Mustang, and the P-47 Thunderbolt.
Mm-hmm.
And it's located about 10 miles south of Cambridge, and that's about 35 miles north of London. So just wanted to mention it. It's been listed as the... one of the top three for the British Tourism Reward for this year for the best new tourism project in Britain, and it's in competition for the first place. But I wanted to mention that.
Well, that sounds like it'd be right down my alley. I'd love to see that.
Yeah, it's great. And if you can work it in, you'll sure enjoy it, Ludlow.
I'm going to take a shot. I got an awful lot I want to see.
Yeah.
But I'll try to work that in. That sounds wonderful.
Right. Well, appreciate your program.
Okay, buddy. You take care of yourself. Yeah. Talk to you soon.
Yeah, okay.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
Cherry Log, Georgia, and my buddy Bud on the radio. Hello, old friend.
Hello, Ludlow.
How you doing?
Boy, every year about this time, the day before Thanksgiving, say something comes to my mind.
What's that?
Have you ever heard from that fella about the turkey next door, if he's ever is still married?
No, I don't think so.
I don't think so either. I just wondered, he ain't never called back, has he?
No. So we'll, if we can find that, we're going to play it sometime during the holidays. We're looking for it.
Yeah,
right,
we need to do that, because we got to have that. Of course, you know, the best way to eat turkey, you know, they're frying and all this stuff.
Yeah.
Ain't one way to cook that thing. That's smoky.
Yeah, I like them smoked.
Oh, yeah. You know, got to have them smoked. I smoked 105 last week.
Oh, yeah. You knew it was coming, didn't you?
Yeah, getting ready for it. That 12-pound turkey breast, too. You know, it takes a big old turkey to produce a 12-pound breast.
It does indeed.
Yeah. Governor called me a while ago, and he wanted to come by this afternoon and get his Thanksgiving dinner, Brunswick stew and pork.
That'll do.
So that'll work.
That'll do.
Well, I guess I've had terrible luck trying to get you lately. So, everything going all right?
Everything going well, buddy. I'll see you one of these days soon.
Yeah, looking for you.
All right, pal. You take care of yourself.
All right, talk to you.
Bye-bye. 1-800-572-8255, Ludlow and Denny. It is the Fun Seekers Radio Network, and they were talking about the clouds gathering in Cleveland, Tennessee. The clouds are gathering in Suwannee. That beautiful sunshine I was raving about. It's just about gone. Just about gone. It's still popping in and out, but for the most part, it is getting cloudy here, and say what you will, they warned us. Our number, 1-800-572-8255. That's 1-800-572-TALK. Toll-free call from no matter where you're listening. Jump in here and get involved in the festivities on the Fun Seekers Radio Network.
I'm Dr. J.T. Cooper. You've heard me on Ludlow's show many times talking about weight loss and nutrition. If you have had problems losing unwanted pounds and want help from me in losing weight safely, You can reach me at 770-952-7681. I have offices in Marietta, Griffin, Waycross, and Albany, Georgia. That number again for information is 770-952-7681.
There's a brand new product you need to know about because no matter how good of a housekeeper you are, parts of your home are natural places for lingering unpleasant odors like bathrooms, closets, closed pet areas. You get the idea. Well, FanFresh is a small, lightweight, battery-operated fan that mounts on the wall and eliminates odors 24 hours a day. Call 1-800-237-8400, extension 102, just $29.95 plus shipping. Call now and get your first refill cartridge and battery free. FanFresh.
The race to help is on. The 12th annual Sleigh Bell Run will be held Saturday, December 6th at Bishop Park in Athens. It's sponsored by the East Georgia chapter of the American Red Cross. The one-mile run walk starts at 8 a.m., followed by the 5K Sleigh Bell Run at 8:30. You can register before the race for $12 and $15 on race day. All funds raised at the event will support disaster victims this holiday season. For additional information, contact the East Georgia chapter of the American Red Cross, 353-1645.
News.
Leadoff witness Richard Sullivan will be grilled on the activities of his course. Said we simply will not have the capacity at some of the larger schools for natural
growth.
John
Linder says he hopes the House can begin hearings of its own later this year.
Weather.
The area with a high of 78. I'm meteorologist Kathy Francis.
Traffic.
Making Highway looks fine, and so do Prince Avenue and Baxter Street.
Sports.
Robert Yates has told Ernie Irvin to find another racing team.
The Athens Morning Update on News Radio 960, the new WRFC.
Hey, you listen to the Ludlow Port Show weekdays, 10 to noon on News Radio 960, the new WRFC.
I don't do much cooking, you know. Back during Thanksgiving, Ma Crabapple had the flu. She was in bed for about 2 weeks, and she always cooks turkey for Thanksgiving. Everybody was coming over to eat. She said, "You're going to have to cook that turkey." I said, "Well, I don't know nothing about cooking a turkey." She said, "Well, just go to the supermarket and buy one." Said, "They got the directions right on the side of it." Said, "You can't miss. Just do what it says to do." So I cooked the turkey for Thanksgiving dinner. Everybody got over there to eat, and we sat down at the table, and I got that roasting pan out and took the top off of it, and that turkey was burnt to a crisp. It was about the size of a softball and looked like a piece of charcoal. She said, "How long you been cooking that turkey?" I said, "About 8 days." I said, "It said right on the side of it, cook an hour per pound." I said, "I figure I weighed about 180.
1-800-572-8255. The more than marvelous Jim Clip on the radio. Hello, Jim.
Well, how y'all doing this morning?
Doing great, buddy. How about you?
Oh, couldn't be better.
Good.
Just sitting around enjoying life. Now, I'm thinking about these Thanksgiving traditions y'all are talking about. Seems everybody has a individual tradition.
Mm-hmm.
One of our traditions is banana pudding. Why? I don't know.
Just father to son or mama to daughter. That's the way those things get handed down.
And, of course, both ham and turkey got to have both of them.
Mm-hmm.
But go back to the original Thanksgiving Day. You know, everybody assumes that the pilgrims had turkey and venison and pumpkin pie and all like that. But only one record survives that tells anything about what they had to eat that day.
And that says they went to Shawnee's. Remember that?
No.
Different one?
But do you know the only dish that is known for sure that they served that day?
What?
Popcorn.
No, that's very, very interesting.
That is the only thing that's known for sure.
Very interesting. I wonder what the movie was.
You know, when the pilgrims left England, what was their destination?
You talking about the New World? I mean, they were looking for New England, I guess.
No, they had a charter to settle within a half a day's walk of Jamestown, Virginia. And they got caught in the Gulf Stream,
uh-huh.
And it took them about a week to get out of it. And when they got out of it, that's where they were, in Massachusetts.
Wow, and welcome to the new world in the wintertime.
Yeah, they wanted to be where they'd have contact with Jamestown, you know, that, which makes sense. You know, being the only two colonies in the new world.
Yeah, I wonder if they knew where they were. I guess
highly unlikely.
Yeah.
They just, after that experience with the Gulf Stream, they probably just want to get to some land.
Yeah, get something to stand on.
Yeah. Talking about turkeys, you know the best way to keep a turkey in suspense?
Turn the lights out? I don't know. What's the best way? I beg your pardon. Walked right into that. Walked right into that. Leading a lamb to the slaughter.
Yeah. I thought you'd heard that.
No, I hadn't. But I'm sure I'll hear it again.
You know, we normally have, for the last 28, 25 years anyway, I have a big to-do here and with anywhere from 30 to 40 people.
Mm-hmm.
And this year, because of my wife's involvement elsewhere, it's going to be at my daughter's house. And it's about to drive my wife crazy.
Yeah.
She don't know what to do with herself, you know. In constant contact with my daughter, you're going to do this? You got this right?
She's acting as a technical advisor.
Well, yeah.
Yeah.
Unsolicited technical advisor.
Freelance.
But, I you do something for 20, 25 years, and it's kind of rough to just drive it off, you know.
That's exactly right. That's
I've had, we sent out invitations to all the people that come with directions from the daughter's house, and this sort of thing, and they still call me. Well, why? Why? You know, everybody's used to coming here.
Yeah, you don't fool with the tradition.
No. And I kind of like it.
Yeah.
I still get to see them all in my daughter's house, but sometimes, that's the only time of the year I got to see some.
Yeah, yeah. And that's another thing. We were talking about jump-starting incidentally, we just found, if you hear any bugles, we just found the turkey neck story. There we go. So we'll hear that during the holidays.
Okay.
All right, buddy. Listen, you, in spite of your change of venue, have a great, great Thanksgiving.
I'll certainly do it, and the same to you, Howard.
I'll talk to you soon.
Yeah, I'll be sweet.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
Blue Ridge, Georgia, and Bobo. Hello, Brother Bobo. Where you been?
I've been right here.
All right.
You know right here?
Yeah.
Ah, Luddy, I just called to tell you hello and wish you a happy Thanksgiving.
Well, buddy, I appreciate you checking in.
And being the good recovering alcoholic that I am, I wanted to put out over your radio network that the only reason that a man has to be by himself from now till January the 1st is because he chooses to be. You know, from now till January the 1st is the worst time in the world for alcoholics.
Really? Yeah, I guess so. I guess so.
Yeah, lonesome.
Mm-hmm.
And they tend to isolate, and when they isolate, you know, when I'm by myself, I'm my own worst enemy.
Yeah.
Now, you just think about that a minute. When I'm by myself, I'm my own worst enemy.
Yeah, well, you sound like you won a big battle here, buddy.
Oh, well, I ain't won it, but I'm still fighting.
Yeah.
You know, you never win it.
Mm-hmm.
When they place me in the ground and throw dirt in my face is when I won it.
Yeah.
That's when I get my graduation certificate. But, Luddy, y'all have a good one.
All right, buddy. It's always fun when you call. I want you to stay in close touch with us.
Oh, by all means. But you know something I found out up here in these North Georgia mountains? It's sight and world how many folks listen to you.
Yeah, wonderful.
They you know they have identified old Bobo.
Oh, yeah.
I'm too well known up here. Of course, I'm 60 year old and I ain't never lived outside the city limits of Blue Ridge.
Well, you're part of the countryside.
Bloody come to see you.
All right, buddy, I'll see you soon.
All right,
bye-bye. And what we're going to do is, after this next break, we're going to play that turkey neck story for you. Stay with us. I want to tell you about some big doings at Jasper Dodge. Yeah, I said Jasper Dodge in Jasper, Georgia. Now, don't worry. You'll find them right in the middle of Jasper Jeep, Dodge, Chrysler, Plymouth. But there's something new up there I got to tell you about. It's the Dodge Durango. Yes, sir. It's new, and it's large and in charge. Big enough for the whole family. Four-wheel drive. You can take it to the woods, or you can drive it slap to Waco, Texas. You're going to love it. But you got to see it to really, really appreciate it. The brand new Durango from Dodge. I want you to see it now at Jasper Dodge. Can't miss it, right in the middle of Jasper Jeep, Dodge, Chrysler, Plymouth in Jasper, Georgia. Now, they're open Monday through Saturday, 8 a.m. to 7 p.m., but never, ever on Sunday. You take a trip up there, because I'm here to tell you, gang, no matter where you live, your Jeep, Dodge, Chrysler, Plymouth dealer is in beautiful Jasper, Georgia. Tell them I sent you.
You're an Army Reserve supply specialist. Thanks to you, the 12 cases of medication on this truck will make it to your field hospital exactly when they're needed. That's how reserve training makes you a better manager. You're an Army Reserve practical nurse. The doctors and RNs look to you for your knowledge and expertise. That's how reserve training builds confidence. Be all that you can be. Call 1-800-USA-ARMY, paid for by the Army Reserve.
It has arrived. The day when you stop listening to the tales of other lives lived and begin the odyssey that will be your story. When you find the destiny to which you were born. All you need to bring with you is your honor, your courage, and your commitment. It's your journey. Make it a good one.
Call 1-800-USA-NAVY. Let the journey begin.
Paid for by the U.S. Navy.
Kit Kat break time here on the quad, where everyone's happily cramming for finals. Oh, yeah. Who wants a study break? Oh, who wants a study break with a Kit Kat bar? Oh, yeah. Sing me the Kit Kat song and you'll get one.
Yeah. Give me a break. Give me a break. Break me off a piece of that Kit Kat bar. Give me a break. Give me a break. I want to take a break with that Kit Kat bar.
All right. Kit Kat break time. Now let's all sing Kumbaya.
Spend lunch with ABC News.
The President's Advisory Board on Race held its first meeting today. ABC's Bill Greenwood with a story.
WRFC's extensive coverage of top local news.
Here's a look at the top stories we'll be covering this afternoon. Hall County officials are
Paul Harvey
to
News and Comment.
Hello, Americans. I'm Paul Harvey.
And Channel 2 Action News.
And the mistrial is our top story on Channel 2 Action News at noon. I'm Chris Curl.
And I'm Marion Brooks.
It's the Athens Noon Update on News Radio 960, the new WRFC.
Hi, gang, this is Ludlow Forge, and if you're not listening to the Fun Seekers Network, just see what you're missing. Join me weekdays, 10 to noon, on News Radio 960, the new WRFC. All right, every place I've been on this book signing tour, people have collared me and said, are you going to replay the tape where the guy told the turkey neck story? And this happened about a year ago, and this is one of those things that just keeps on with the chuckles. So here it is for everybody that asked for it, the turkey neck tape. (1-800-572-8255) Getting some great tacky stories. Let's go to Albany, Georgia, and talk to Bobby on the radio. Hello, Bobby.
Hello, Lila. How are you?
I'm great, pal. You all right?
Good, good. True story. A newly elected judge came to speak to our civic club, and he was talking about why he wanted to become a judge. He had been a divorce attorney for 14 years. He said he just wanted to lead a more normal life, that he had heard so many stories and had so much fight, and especially around the holidays. He said it was always worse around the holidays. For an example, he said he had a young lady come to him, and they'd only been married a couple months. Said she wanted to get a divorce because her husband was just too crude. And he kept asking her what she meant by too crude. She couldn't tell him. He said, well, I've got to know. You've got to tell me, you know, what do you mean by he's just too crude? She said, well, all right. She said, I invited my family over for Thanksgiving dinner. My husband got up to carve the turkey on the sidebar. When he turned around, he had the turkey neck hanging out of his fly. Right in front of my mama. And they got divorced.
And if I'd have been on the jury, I'd have given her the house and the car and the rest of that turkey.
And that's true story. That's well known among the legal community here, but that's an actual true story.
That is a classic. That is. And when was the mother's funeral? Because I know it killed the mama.
I didn't hear about that, but that was too much for her daughter.
Oh, that's a funny story. I'm glad you called. Do it again, Bobby.
Okay, thank you.
Take care.
Bye. Bye-bye.
Oh, Denny, you ever met that guy? Oh, I need to pull myself together. I got to do a radio show here. Oh, this show may be over, gang. How you gonna top that? Tacky? Oh, let's go to Cleveland, Tennessee and talk to Doug.
There isn't any way to top that. We will.
Oh. You're talking about the Tacky Hall of Fame.
That goes right up in there with too high for the dogs to reach.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
That should be immortalized.
It may already have been. That is really something. And we're talking about Thanksgiving. His mother-in-law was wearing her best pearls.
That's amazing.
And wouldn't you like to know how far she spit the mashed potatoes? Oh,
that's
funny.
This guy must have been in a riot in college.
Oh, yeah. Before he got mature and settled down, yeah. He was a real prankster. All right. There you have it. Somebody called and said to get it off the air with lowering the standards. You can please some of the people, et cetera, et cetera. Got to get out of here. Listen, you have a great, great Thanksgiving. Until we get together again, whatever else you do today, you find somebody to be nice to.
Classic City and Northeast Georgia. This is News Radio 960, the new WRFC, Athens, a Southern Broadcasting Company's radio station.
Good afternoon. I'm Mark Alewine, and this is the Athens Noon Update on News Radio 960, the new WRFC. Currently sunny skies, 56 degrees on South Millage Avenue.
I'm meteorologist Kathy Francis. Your official three-day forecast is just minutes away on News Radio 960, the new WRFC.
Some of the stories we're following for you this noon. If you're going to be driving today, AAA says you're going to have a lot of company as the Thanksgiving holiday gets underway. An Athens man facing murder charges after a deadly shooting yesterday off of Timothy Road. Plus,
another ruling goes against the defense in the Five Points rapist case. This is WRFC's Indra Sybil. That story's coming up on the Athens Noon Update.
I'm David Johnston with sports, where the Georgia Bulldogs got a win last night over in-state rival Georgia Southern, and the Hawks look to take it to Toronto again this evening.
Taking a look at Wall Street at this hour, the Dow Jones 30 Industrials down about 3 points, the NASDAQ Composite Index is up 4 points, and the Standard & Poor's 500 up almost 2 points. News Radio 960, WRFC News Time is 12 o'clock. Now let's get the latest from ABC News.
From ABC News. I'm John Belmont. A bad start to the long holiday weekend in Meridian, Mississippi, where 7 people have died in a van crash on I-20. 10 people were packed into the van when it went off the interstate and into a tree.
This is the busiest travel day of the year.
We have a cinnamon raisin bagel with light cream cheese.
Meaning a lot of cars and a lot of snacks at this rest stop on the Garden State Parkway in New Jersey. Meaning plane loads of passengers packed into Miami International Airport. This woman coping fine thanks to her Thanksgiving travel strategy.
Start early, pack early, get here early, and get on your plane and go.
Checking in from Boston's Logan Airport, reporter Carl Stevens of ABC affiliate WBZ.
There's a steady stream of travelers flying out of the airport here, John, going to see the family for Thanksgiving. And officials here are trying to make this part of the journey fun. They've set up separate areas for kids to play and even have members of the Boston Ballet dancing in various terminals. John?
No doubt doing a grand jeté. Bill Clinton has given the annual presidential pardon to an overstuffed bird.
I'm granting this turkey a permanent reprieve. After many years in the coop, he's on his way to a farm in Virginia to bask in the sun, collect his hard-earned pension, enjoy his golden years. And that's one less turkey in Washington.
Yesterday, the defense secretary said if the U.S. military has to deflate the ego of Saddam Hussein, it will be more than a pinprick. Today, the Marine general in command of our Persian Gulf forces says much more.
I will assure you it is far more than a pinprick. In the case of our forces being attacked or in the case of a response to an unacceptable act.
General Anthony Zinni at the Pentagon this morning. A new type of treatment for the cancer that killed Jacqueline Kennedy Onassis, non-Hodgkin's lymphoma. This newly approved procedure kills off cancer cells by finding them and binding to them. We're told it means fewer side effects. You're listening to ABC News.
All cars are built to be practical. Few are built to be passionate. And only the great ones are built to appeal to your practical side and your passionate side. The 1998 Chrysler Cirrus LXi. For the passionate, cab-forward design, remote keyless entry, multi-valve V6, ABS, air conditioning, power windows and door locks, a 6-speaker premium sound system, even an 8-way power driver's seat, and, at no extra charge, a new luxurious leather-trimmed interior. For the practical side, the 1998 Chrysler Cirrus LXi with all this is just $18,995. Loaded, the Chrysler Cirrus LXi, built in the belief that while all cars are built to appeal to our practical side, the great ones appeal to our passionate side. Chrysler, engineered to be great cars. Base sticker price after $1,000 cash back includes destination tax extra.
Late word out of Sacramento that a SWAT team has raided a motel room and found a large stash of cash, but there's no sign of the man police are looking for, an armored car guard who's suspected of killing his partner and taking almost $300,000. 10 years probation for a 14-year-old Houston boy who was turned in by his parents after a convenience store stick-up. They spotted him on a security camera video that was played on...